good? I'm Ross from My Wellness Dojo. Make My Wellness Dojo your wellness dojo. Subscribe at the bottom. Boom. What's good? I'm Ross. And if you're like me and you have neck issues, maybe you've been foam rolling, maybe you're trying to stretch your neck and nothing really works, you may have come across different products like these ones exhibited here. I haven't found much success with them, but I did want to try the Iron Neck. You may have come across it. The Iron Neck can sit and be attached to your head. It gives the ability to train with a singular resistance that rotates around your skull. Just a word of caution, if you're someone with a serious neck injury or even back injury, go really light on this, especially when twisting or causing a torsion effect. It can jack your vertebrae up pretty bad, but let's go ahead and check this puppy out. No matter what kind of traction I do and stretching and warm up and foam rolling, my neck always seems to have pain. I want to try the Iron Neck. It makes a lot of sense that if you're putting your neck under all this pressure and you're just stretching it and you're really not strengthening it, that could be a large reason of why those neck muscles tend to get injured so easily. And this product seemed really great, so I wanted to unbox it and see what there was to offer. There's three models. There's the junior, the varsity, and the pro. This is the varsity. It's the middle of the road one, and this one also actually rotates, which is one of those really unique selling points that these products have. You can rotate and add resistance. I think the difference with this one is you can't actually change the resistance on the rotation, but let's go ahead and check it out. What I also did was opt for the 30-day trial. You're just paying for shipping just in case it didn't really work out. But I'm pretty optimistic. Some action happening there. General movements, although they've already been emailing me some YouTube lessons and everything like that. Oh, wow, okay. So it looks like it comes with a heavyweight band that I ordered. You pay a few, like $5 or $10 extra for the band itself, the heavier one, which I wanted to go with. Not to say that I'm so strong or anything, but with this kind of thing, I feel like I get strong pretty quick. We got some spacers here for the headgear for a fit. I know that you can pump it up too. I believe this is actually how we attach it to a clip and then probably to the rope. And then of course you got your Iron Neck hat. That's gonna look dope as you know what. But this is the actual product. Wow, it feels really big. Do not exceed 15 pumps and deflate after every use. Here, now that I got the hat on, I feel really thugged out. It's pretty comfortable. So let's see how it goes. All right, I guess I'm ready to go. Here we are again in my $3.785 million facility. And just a quick note about mounting the Iron Neck. It should be about to your height, to about your forehead. I've got some TRX mounts in concrete because I didn't want to be whack as fuck and break my neck in my own home. But I actually had to use these mounts on my garage door because it was a better height to just get better performance. Something to think about before you buy this thing. So I'm ready to start using the Iron Neck. One important thing that was a little hard to find is the pump. You can pump it here to make sure it's tight enough on your head, and then there's a release button here, just like the Reebok pumps or the Nike Air pumps back in the day, so nobody here should have that much trouble. That's the pump right there. It fits pretty good, even though I feel like Doc Brown from Back to the Future. Now let's go ahead and get started. That was my first workout. I followed the sets, basically how they laid it out. It was turn left, turn right 5 times, in four directions, two sets of those, and then two sets of 10 reps, 360 degree turns. But I did about the same amount of work. I feel a little bit, you know, like I use the muscles. When it comes to my neck and my back, I tend to take it easy. You know, if I'm okay the next day, I might do 20% more. I don't want to jack my neck up too bad. I want to be able to roll the next few days and work out. So I'd rather take it lighter and be able to train a little bit more than kind of go overboard, especially when it's something brand new. My neck has never experienced something exactly like this. The workout itself was not very hard, which I didn't expect it to be. It's not like, you know, if I'm fatiguing my neck, I'm probably jacking it up in a really bad way. I don't know, for something that, you know, with tax and everything and a big discount, this middle of the road model was about $400. It just felt a little clunky in the rotation. I mean, I'm not a ball bearing expert or a machine expert, but you know, for that much money, I feel like it should feel a little smoother. Bottom line, if it helps me reduce neck pain and prevent injuries and stuff like that, I'm sure my neck is jacked from years of, you know, use and damage and everything, I'll be happy with it. Like I said, I've got 30 days of the first time I've worked out in it. So how do I feel overall about this product? So I've had it about 40 days. I've probably had 10 workouts, give or take, maybe a few more. I've progressively gotten a lot harder. I haven't had any issues with my neck. In fact, I will honestly say that in terms of the claims, I haven't really had any neck pain that I can think of. One of the main reasons is that just because you're strengthening your neck, but I think what it also does is strengthen the problem areas, your rhomboids between your shoulder blades back here. If you get that pain behind your shoulder blades like I get on and off, because when you're actually setting up, you can fix your posture to train your rhomboids at the same time. That's something I'm gonna kind of get into in some other videos. You can stretch in different ways that you can't really do using your arms on the ground because you have that external resistance. You can relax your shoulders into the right spot. You can move around with some static strengthening exercises. So overall, I think it's a great product. The main pros are it's unique. I can't find anything out there. The ability to stretch, strengthen, and provide traction, definitely. And the bonus, reduce that shoulder pain. So the cons, there's three of them. One of them, the major cons, is the overall cost. The three different models vary from $250 to $450 to $650. I've got the one in the middle. Like I've said, it cost me about $400 with a discount and with shipping. This is the varsity model. I just feel like it's relatively expensive. I mean, even at the higher end, it's $650, so I feel like maybe 30% less would just be my general opinion. But the other thing is, as I've mentioned, it feels a little rickety there because it seems like it's just wearing on plastic.
that is not really, really going to be that durable. So that's the one reason, because this is plastic and the friction from the actual part, it seems like it might not last that long. It's just my impression. My one final con also is the size of the carabiner design here. I know these are relatively standard, but when you have this on top of your head, actually snapping this in is kind of a pain in the ass. It kind of just barely fits. And this is easy to do here, but when it's on my head, it's very hard to do. So that would be my main beef. I mean, there are square carabiners that I think possibly provide a better design. This does also give you a lot of movement, but the size of it, I feel like, could have been designed a little better. Overall, I ended up keeping it. Obviously, I think it worked extremely well for what it's supposed to do. The bottom line, especially if you're a grappler, but even if you have neck pain, I would definitely buy it at a discounted rate.
So based on a value scale nearly identical to the one that NASA uses, rating effectiveness, does this product do what they say they do, value, is it worth the money, and overall, how awesome and amazing is it? So for effectiveness, I'm going to give it 4.5 takedowns or sweeps, because it pretty much does what it says they do, and it is very effective for other added benefits that I will get into in other videos. In terms of value, yes, it is a good product, but I feel it is overpriced. So as a Jew, I'm only going to give it 3.5 stars of David. And then overall, yes, I'm going to give it 4 Buddha heads. While it is a great product, and yes, I did pay a somewhat exorbitant price for it and think it's great, there's a couple things I didn't think were incredible about it. So that's why it's 4 stars and not more. Stay tuned for my other videos. I'm going to do a follow-up on how to hack the iron neck and some creative workouts to do for it. I'm Ross Gottlieb, aka Jew Jackman, and this has been My Wellness Dojo.